why should we not pursue robots? In terms of the first idea about whether or not this creates a race, we say, yes, it potentially could. That doesn't undermine the idea that states have an obligation to enter into that race and try and win it, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't undermine the idea that we should not refrain from entering into the race for fear that someone will actually develop something better. We say it's more of a reason to get involved in it and develop the technology yourself, ladies and gentlemen, because states have that duty towards their military, ladies and gentlemen. On the second idea, that robots apparently can do it better. And here we get to hear some interesting analysis, to say the least. They talked about the idea that apparently we should actually just pursue robots, these people can, can just bomb things and whatever else. In the same breath, Johnny Dan said what he didn't want to do was brutalize warfare. In the same breath, he said he wants to modernize civilian warfare. And what we say is our option better does that. And why does that, ladies and gentlemen? We say machines can never calculate risk as effectively as humans.
Ladies and gentlemen, we also
got before me. They said one of the most important things is an ability to communicate with those on the ground. We said giving the soldiers the capacity to learn a language in a few days, giving them the ability for the mental capacity to absorb that Arabic language in a few days is a very good way to be able to communicate with. So again, we say these soldiers should do benefit.